एज यू कैन सी आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज सिक्योर इलेक्ट्रॉनिक ट्रांजेक्शन एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट बिकॉज दिस प्रोटोकॉल वी आर यूजिंग इन आर डे टू डे लाइफ वेन एवर वी डू दी ऑनलाइन ट्रांजेक्शन बाई यूजिंग क्रेडिट कार्ड्स. सो बेसिकली सेट Protocol is a system which ensures security and integrity of electronic transactions done using credit cards. The user must have a credit card. In that case, this protocol comes into picture. This protocol provides services like security, data integrity, authentication of merchant and client, etc. And SET is an open encryption and security specification designed to protect credit card information on the internet. Like by the word encryption, encryption means, suppose for example, if you have this message, secure electronic transaction, this is the message and I have to send this message to the to some other another person. So if I use encryption to encrypt this message, which consists of three words, and I can convert or transform this message into some XYZ like this. So basically, encryption is a process which means or which converts an intelligent message or a readable message into some scrambled message which cannot be read or which is difficult to understand. So the SET protocol is supported by Microsoft IBM, MasterCard, which you use, Visa, Netscape, and others also. SET is not itself a payment system. Rather, it is a set of security protocols and formats that enables user to employ the existing credit card payment infrastructure on an open network. This SET protocol provides three services. Basically, provides a secure communication channel among all parties involved in transaction. Second, provides trust by the use of X.509 version 3 digital certificate. This is a certification mechanism. You can also check the certificate like this. I can show you. If you use the internet, suppose some now suppose if you want to check the certificate or any website, for example of X.509 certificate, so go to the this lock symbol and you can check the certificate. So here in the details you can see the version is V3, version 3, serial number of the certificate, signature algorithm, this is SHA or 256 RSA is used. RSA is a encryption algorithm, or then signature hash algorithm, SHA-256 is used. Issuer name is likha hua hai, like valid from 24 March 19 till 25 October 2021. Subject is this. Not .net, pnb.com, this is, and public key is RSA, is an encryption algorithm as I have told you. So this is the certificate which I am talking about. So let's see the third point. It also ensures the privacy because the information is only available to parties in a transaction when and where necessary. So this is the diagram or description of this protocol. How many peoples or persons are involved in this whole scenario? The main entities are, number one, the cardholder or the customer. Here is the customer. Second is the merchant or the web server, because the merchant is not physically present over the physically present, because as we have studied in e-commerce and traditional commerce, in traditional commerce the merchant has some retail store over some place, but in the case of e-commerce the merchant need not to have a physical existence. So merchant is the web server. Merchant bank, merchant must have some bank payment, which will be payment gateway acquirer. Payment gateway is a device operated by an acquirer. Sometimes separate these two entities, kabhi kabhi ye dono entity different bhi hoti hai. Issuer is the cardholder's bank. Jo cardholder hoga uska bank jo hai is called the issuer. And what is the purpose of said protocol? Is the purpose of said protocol is to establish payment transaction that provide confidentiality of information, ensures the integrity of payment instructions. If you whenever you order something from your application or Myntra or Zivame or Zomato, there are two things: the payment information and order information. Payment information, order information consists of the items and the total amount. Suppose you have ordered one item, then you must pay for one item, or you will receive only one item. So this information remain constant. It must not be changed during the transit. Suppose आपने one item order किया, लेकिन जब receiver merchant के पास पहुंचा तो वो five item हो गए. तो it means the data is altered by some unauthorized person or unauthorized access. So this must not be done. It also authenticate both the cardholder and the merchant. So this is the description, brief description of the person cardholder. In electronic environment, a cardholder is an authorized holder of payment, like me and you. We all are using some kind of card, so we are the cardholders that has been issued by an issuer. जो हमें card hold जो card है वो किसी bank ने हमें issue किया है. Merchant, a merchant is a person or organization that has goods or services to sell, like Flipkart, Amazon. They are the merchants, sell to the cardholder. Typically these goods and services are offered via a website or electronic mail. A merchant that accepts payment card must have a relationship with an acquirer. Issuer, this is an financial institution such as a bank that provides the card holder with the payment card. Acquirer, this is a financial institution that establishes an account with a merchant and processes payment card authorization and payments. Merchant will usually accept more than one card brand, but do not want to deal with the multiple card bank association with multiple individual issuers. So the issuer provides authorization to merchant that a given card account is active. When you try to do the payment, then there are some authorization process which runs in the background, that your sometimes you got the message like your card is not valid for this transaction, or your card do not have sufficient amount for doing the transaction. So this kind of authentication is done in the background, and this is done by the acquirer. Payment gateway, this is a function operated by the acquirer or a designated third party. The payment gateway interface between said protocol and the existing payment network for authorization and payment functions. The merchant exchanges set messages with payment gateway over the internet. And this is the last. Certification authority. This is an entity that is trusted to issue X.509 version 3 public key certificate for the cardholder merchant payment gateway. The success of SET will depend on the existence of certification authority infrastructure available for this purpose. So this is the here is the working of this protocol, how this works. Both cardholder, there are some steps and you must cram these steps. Both cardholder and merchant must register with certification authority before they can buy or sell on the internet. After that, once the registration is done, the cardholder and the merchant can start to do the transaction. This includes the following steps. Number one, customer browses website. For ordering something from Myntra, you must browse the website or you must download the Myntra application in your phone like this. This is the first or foremost step. Customer browse the website and decide what to purchase. Second, customer sends order and payment information, which includes two parts in one message. Purchase order. This part is for merchant. How many items you buy and of what size you want to buy and what color, what texture. This information is for the merchant. Card information or payment information. This part is for the merchant's bank only. Merchant, this information will this complete information will go encrypted, and basically the card information is only for the merchant's bank. Merchant is not capable of decrypting the card information of any cardholder. Third point is merchant forward card information to their bank. Merchant receives but cannot read, so merchant directly forward this to their bank. Merchant's bank checks the issuer for payment authorization. Then issuer send authorization to merchant's bank. Next step, merchant's bank send authorization to merchant. Merchant completes the order and sends confirmation to the customer. Merchant captures the transaction from their banks. Issuer prints credit card bill to the customer. Dual signature is used in this. Dual signature is a concept introduced with SET protocol, which aims at connecting two information pieces meant for two different receivers. Like I have told you, order information is for merchant and payment information is for bank only, merchant's bank only. So this is PI. And this is OI, order information. These both are, the hash function is calculated for these two informations. Like this, here we have calculated the hash function. And this, then this is called the concatenation. These two messages are merged. Then again, hash is calculated. So this will become POMD. POMD stands for Payment Order Message Digest, right? This is Payment Information Message Digest. This is Order Information Message Digest. Then these two are combined and again hash is calculated. So this become Payment Order Message Digest. And this POMD is encrypted by using some encryption algorithms. These encryption algorithms can be any, they can be symmetric algorithms, they can be asymmetric algorithms like DES algorithm, RSA algorithm, Diffie-Hellman algorithm. There are a lot of algorithms which can be used to encrypt the message. And this is the key, KPC. This is the key which is used in this public key encryption. And then a dual signature is generated. to protect our information and the order information. So this is the equation for digital signature or dual signature. This here, this is the first step, OI, hash of OI is concatenated with hash of PI, and these two are again hash is calculated from the PMID and OIMD, and then this complete messages encrypted with the help of this public key, and this creates the dual signature. Thank you.